Good afternoon, everyone. Well, nobody wants to pay more for property taxes.
But could paying less do more harm than good? News Channel 8's Keri Gavin has our top story. Keri?
Cynthia, that's the very question local government officials want lawmakers to address. That's because cities and counties rely on the revenue from property taxes to pay for public services.
3 weeks after the 2012 session was scheduled to adjourn, lawmakers still haven't agreed on how to lower property taxes. Governor Branstad called on both parties Monday.
This is something that needs to be done. It's unfinished business from last year, and I think everybody needs to work in good faith to resolve the differences and get it done.
As lawmakers work on legislation that could lower commercial property taxes by as much as $350 million, city and county officials across the state are already concerned about the fallout. Polk County Administrator David Jones.
This would be very significant. It wouldn't be immediate. Both of the House and the Senate proposals both allow for some type of phase-in of the different approaches, which gives us some opportunity to plan, but the real bottom line is we can't absorb this.
Under both proposals, taxes would be reduced for apartment and commercial property owners. Lawmakers supportive of the measure say the tax cut will attract more businesses to Iowa. Jones estimates the loss to Polk County would be between $1.7 and $3.1 million in only the first year.
In Polk County, more than half of all of the dollars that we operate on for all the services that we provide and all of the things that we do in Polk County are paid for with property tax dollars.
Ms. Conley? Yes.
Jones says the Board of Supervisors are starting to discuss what the impending property tax reform would mean for Polk County. Stopping short of saying what services could be on the chopping block, Jones says everything from mandatory services like the Sheriff's Department to non-mandatory services like a flu clinic at the Health Department could be affected.
We're not trying to sound the alarm. We're not alone in this. We recognize that all the cities and counties are in this shape. But at the same time, we have to notify the citizens that this is serious.
Now, it's important to note that both the House and Senate proposals would gradually change, as he said. Jones says whatever version passes would have a significant impact on the county's budget, though. So that's why the Boards of Supervisors is starting to discuss how they will adjust if they have to.